Hi, I'm Steve Ledoux, town manager here in Acton. I've been the town manager here for about 7.5 years, and I've been doing this line of work for 38 years, I kind of hate to admit. And over the years, you know, I've worked in a lot of different communities, dealt with a lot of different issues, but you know, some people have asked me, how did I even get into this kind of line of work? And it's a good question, because I don't think it's the type of profession that, you know, when you're 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, you think about, gee, I want to be a town manager someday. You may want to be a baseball player or a fireman or whatever, but nothing like that. And I think with me, it really started out in high school when I was taking a political science class. And I went to a Catholic high school in Worcester, so there were people from all a bunch of different towns throughout generally Worcester County. And the teacher had us write a paper about our hometown government. And I grew up in Holden that happened to have a town manager. So I actually went to his office, interviewed him to write my paper when I was like 15 years old. And, you know, that kind of was an experience, but I didn't really think too much about that until I got to college. And I was a political science major in college, and really thought I was going to go to law school. And I thought, well, political science made some kind of sense in that regard. So when I went to Notre Dame, and out of a student body of 6,000, 1,000 students were in what they call the pre-law society, which started to make me worried that maybe there's going to be too many lawyers someday. So nonetheless, I started to apply for law schools, and my major professor, Professor John Roos, said, hey, have you ever thought about public administration? And I had taken a class that Professor Roos had taught that basically was an internship, and I worked for the Department of Public Safety in South Bend, Indiana, doing some statistical analysis for them. And so he saw something in me that I hadn't really even thought about. So he advised me to pursue a master's in public administration, excuse me. And I received that, and basically from there on in, I've been doing local government management for the last 38 years. So it's an interesting job. You know, I talk to a lot of young people about it sometimes, and it's a job that's never dull. When you come to work in the morning, you might have a work plan, but you never know actually what you're going to get into, and you know that makes it interesting. Sometimes frustrating, but generally interesting. And it's always a great feeling to work on projects and see projects get done that are really for the good of community. So it's a little about myself, and I know in ongoing months we'll be talking about some of the issues that the town is facing. But appreciate the opportunity to talk to you, and thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Kathy Fochman. I'm the Recreation Director for Town of Acton. And I wanted to give you some updates on what the department is doing these days. We just finished a very successful summer season. We had events happening at the Nara Amphitheater nearly every week. And coupled with that, we had terrific weather. So everything ran. We had a wonderful first time presentation of a Shakespeare play by Walden Shakespeare. It's called Midsummer Night's Dream. In addition to theater, we had many musical performances by a wide range of performers, two ticketed concerts that included the Glenn Miller Orchestra, as well as Tusk, a tribute band to the music of Fleetwood Mac. It's hard with all this intensity to come off of the summer season, but we're now launching into our fall season, and we've got some exciting things yet to come. By the time you hear this announcement, it'll have passed, but we have the Chinese Music and Dance Night. It's happening on August 27th. In addition, upcoming for the fall, we have the Dash and Bash put on by the Middlesex Chamber of Commerce, which is a wonderful 5K race coupled with lots of fun activities, food from local vendors. A very exciting time if you can participate. That's going to be on September 12th. Our traditional fall family campout is happening on Friday, September 18th at Nara Park. You can come to the park on a Friday night and stay overnight with your family. Try out camping if they've never tried it before. It's a wonderful place to do it locally and to have the fun of activities out at NARA at night. Also upcoming this fall, we have the Lions Club. They're putting on a 5K and boot camp challenge. That's going to be on Sunday, October 4th. And children who belong to the local schools, the Acton-Boxborough schools, are invited to participate in this boot camp challenge. It's going to raise money for the home base program, which benefits veterans. Lastly, I have a very important project I'm working on currently. It's called the NARA Master Plan. We have a survey that we've put out to the community that is encouraging people to give their opinions of how they would like to see NARA Park develop over the next 10 years. The survey is available on the town website, and we're looking for your input on both amenities you'd like to see and how you feel the park is currently being run. We'd like to put together all your input and present the report to the public by the end of this fall. So we look forward to your participation in all our activities and certainly our NARA Master Plan. NARA is a wonderful place. If you've not been to 25 Ledge Rock Way in Acton, I encourage you to come visit. It's open all year round, dawn to dusk. And the Recreation Department is working on next year's activities for the park as well. Thank you.
Rich Burrows, Deputy Chief of Police for the Acton Police Department. And we're going to talk about upcoming events for the police department. One of the biggest things we're doing right now is a hiring process. We've recently come out of civil service, and we're looking to hire 6 police officers. We have put a job posting up on the website, and we are also advertising in different police media venues for police officer positions. It's going to be a change from what we typically do with civil service. We hope this is going to give us the opportunity to hire the most qualified candidates available. We've had a lot of interest so far, and a lot of academy-trained officers have applied. That should save us some money in training costs. We estimated the cost at about $35,000 a piece to train police officers that we hire if they're not already academy-trained. So it's a great opportunity for us going forward. The other big thing we have coming up is the next mobilization of the traffic grant. The federal government provides traffic grants for safety to reduce crashes, injuries, and fatalities. The federal fiscal year 2015 grant is going on currently. The latest mobilization is drive sober or get pulled over. We'll have extra officers out on patrol, on overtime, enforcing those laws, looking for impaired operators. The grant will run through Labor Day. Right through till September 7th. Labor Day historically is a bad weekend for accidents. One of the reasons they do these grants is back in 2013, they had over 10,000 people killed on the roads in the United States, 118 just here in Massachusetts. And a high percentage of accidents around Labor Day do involve alcohol and impaired driving. So we're hoping that the increased awareness will reduce those incidents that we encounter.
So we are we're part of the town of Acton. We're a department. We do the public health in town, as well as we are a certified visiting nursing service. So we do home visits. We supply nursing therapies and home health aides to people in Acton and the surrounding towns under the care of a doctor after an injury, a surgical procedure, or any type of illness that is keeping them within their homes. We also do public health for the town, a couple upcoming flu clinics that we're doing this year. One is Thursday, September 24th. That'll be done here at the town hall in room 204. The second will be Saturday, September 26th. That will be done at the COA on Audubon Drive. 50 Audubon Drive from 9 to 12. With the upcoming flu season, we do get a lot of calls and concerns. It's always good to make sure that you're having good hand hygiene, making sure you're wiping down doorknobs and things like that, just to make sure that you're not carrying germs around. Cough etiquette, coughing into your sleeve is always a good practice, because flu season obviously can be a time of angst for people, especially those with other respiratory diseases, for the very young and for the elderly. I believe the biggest health challenge in Acton is Lyme disease. We have a lot of Lyme disease in town. The state doesn't track it as they used to, so the exact numbers I don't know, but there are quite a few people that we have dealt with in town that have long-term issues from Lyme disease. It's always good to make sure you do a check for ticks immediately after being in an outdoor activity. That means on your clothing also, not just checking your hair. Always a good thing to just do a once-over of yourself to make sure. Walking in high grass, if you can tuck your pant legs, if you happen to have jeans or slacks on, into your boots or socks is always a good thing, and just making sure that there's nothing, you know, that's crawled up your legs or up the sleeves of your arms.
We're really excited about the 125th anniversary of the library that's coming up. The library was given to the town by William Wild, who was a native of Acton, who went on to become a successful businessman. And the library was given to the town in honor of the Civil War veterans and dead, hence the name Acton Memorial Library. And it's very interesting, as I talk to people, sometimes people who have lived in Acton for many, many years don't realize that's why it's called Acton Memorial Library. So we have a number of events and activities coming up for the 125th. One of the first events is on September 13th, which is a Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock. It's called Victorian Lady. It is fashion of the time period when the library first opened in 1890. She says there'll be a lot of coverage of underwear. And it's something that people will have the opportunity to try on some garments of that time period. The second event is also a Sunday afternoon, the 20th, also at 3 o'clock. And it's the Etiquette Expert of 1890. And it's sort of a tongue-in-cheek look at what etiquette was like in the 1890s, the things that people would have, well-bred people, would have been expected to know and do at that time. And then a third activity on a Sunday afternoon, on the 27th, also at 3 o'clock, is a concert of music and singing from 1890 to 1920, which would have, of course, been the early years of the library. And then for events, the last one is Wednesday, September 30th at 7 p.m. And Brewster Conant, who's lived in Acton for a number of years, and Susan Maycock are going to talk about the history of the library and its architecture. So that should be great fun and a must for all history buffs in town. In addition to the specific activities we have going on, or events going on, I should say, we have some other things going on. One is that we will have a timeline of the library's history and a quiz to go with it. And in it, you will learn such interesting things as, well, what year did the library have first have a telephone? And this surprised me. It was 1962. Now, some of that was also, I believe that was about the time period when the library expanded from being open from 2 days a week to three. So that may have been part of the cause behind the telephone. There were actually no morning library hours until the late 1960s. And another interesting piece it came up with is when the library opened, there was gas lighting it. And then in 1902, which is only about 12 years after the library opened, of course, they converted it to electric lighting. But I think that's something that at least I had never thought of. I always thought it'd been electric all along. Another thing that we are doing is a display of titles, one from each year of the library's existence. And of course, in more recent years, we have lots and lots of choices. But in for some of the earlier years, it's kind of been a challenge for some of the reference staff to come up with, they were delegated this job of finding titles, to come up with some titles. This is a great time of year to remind people of the many activities that we have going on during the school year at the library. One is that we do a family movie night for kids up to age about 10 or 12, one Friday night a month, including popcorn. We also shortly will start up our PJ story time, which is Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. You know, great way for working parents to have an occasion to bring their children to the library. The PJs are optional, I should add. There is also a drop-in story time at 10 o'clock on Thursday mornings. Once again, now the PJ story time and the drop-in story time are both for ages approximately 3 to 7, and typically include some stories, some activities, a simple craft, that kind of thing. And then, of course, there are a number of things that go on for adults. There is a book group that meets once a month, and we also have a series of computer classes and workshops. If you need help with that, or you want to learn something new in regard to computer and electronics and communication, coming up in October, we'll have a number of programs on archaeology. We do a couple of adult film series a year. Lots and lots of things going on at the library year-round, and you can, best way to do it, keep an eye on a local paper, keep an eye on our local TV station, of course, and also look on the library's event calendar, which is on our website, which, not surprisingly, is www.actonmemoriallibrary.org.
Hi, I'm Doug Halley. I'm the Health Director and Transportation Coordinator for the Town of Acton. I want to talk about the transportation services that the town is currently offering and what the future services will be. Currently, we have 4 vans that are operated by the Town of Acton. They serve a variety of needs throughout the community. We have the rail shuttle, which picks up people at parking lots, both at the fire station and at the Mount Calvary parking lot, and brings people to the train station each morning, picks them up in the evening, and brings them back to the parking lots. We also have 3 door-to-door services. The first one is the Council on Aging van, which is dedicated to seniors and people with disabilities and takes them to appointments and other needs that they have during the course of the week. We have the Roadrunner, which is has a priority for seniors and people with disabilities, but also takes on other people that might need trips in the community. And then we have the Dollar Ride, which is focused on the general population and helping them to make their trips around the community and get to the places that they want to go to. Right now, we're working on a special project, the Town of Acton's first fixed route shuttle, which will be beginning in October 1st, and it's going to be operating Monday through Friday, 10 hours a day, through a variety of trips through the community. We have 3 alternative routes that we're looking at right now. Those alternative routes each have about 13 to 15 stops that we might be considering. So we're looking for a public input on which route is the best route and which stops people most want to see. Behind me, you will see alternative A, which shows the route. And above that, we have alternative C. The other alternative we have is alternative B. These routes and stops are going to be posted on the town's website, and we're looking for people to give input. But primarily, we believe that our customers are going to be people along Great Road that live in the apartment complexes, seniors and people with disabilities, and the school-aged children from 12 to 16 looking to get trips to places they need to go after school closes. So we're very excited about this program, and we can't wait to get it started and see what the public feels about it. Right now, we're anticipating calling it Cross Acton Transit, which will be the CAT, and we're hoping that everybody will come and ride the CAT. Thank you.
Probably the biggest topic right now is the transfer station. The town is adopting a new pay-as-you-throw program. It's different than the prior years in which we had a one-time sticker fee for the entrance into the station, and it was sort of allowed unlimited recycling and trash disposal. Under this program, through the state, the theory is that it gives incentive to recycling, so that it's very similar into the old program. The only difference is now you have to use Acton designated trash bags to dispose of your trash. The theory that is put out there and that other communities have seen work is that people pay for each bag of trash that they dispose of, hence it promotes more recycling and reduces the waste stream that comes in, and thus reducing the town's cost for disposal of it. So that'll be starting September 1st. The sticker programs start then, and there's a 30-day grace period, so over the course of the month, people will be getting their new stickers, but the new bags will be required as of September 1. And we're looking forward to trying to work with people and sort of make it a success. So we've been getting some calls and taking that into consideration for different kind of changes or improvements we can do to make it better. So we're looking forward to the coming weeks and see how it goes. So it was a rough winter last year. We've been going through that. We've actually been working with FEMA on some reimbursements because they did declare the Juno storm federal emergency. So we were working on that, getting some reimbursements. And the last I heard, the Farmer's Almanac is predicting a similar winter. So time will tell, I guess. So we're actively working towards that. And the mechanics are doing what they always do and fixing up the plows and getting them ready and kind of getting ready for the next round. It's something no one really likes to look forward to, but it comes inevitably, so. We have about a dozen dump trucks that you'll see out with the sander beds on and that, and then we hire a series of private contractors to help assist, so whether they come with dump trucks down to pickup trucks with plows. So we try to dispatch out in teams so that they're working on the streets and trying to keep them open. And the contractors are used a lot more last year, but depending on the storm, so the guys will handle a lot. If it gets to be too big of a storm, we bring them in, and it just helps us try to keep up with the storms. And then we use our staff for, after the storm is done, for a cleanup and removal of snow in certain parts of town that just isn't storage. So the highway guys are working on a lot of drainage improvements in West Acton, trying to improve things up sort of the Duggan Road area. We're constantly working on sidewalks, trying to work with the sidewalk committee, getting sidewalk projects going. We'll be hopefully starting a retaining wall on High Street down by Valley Road soon to facilitate a construction of a sidewalk from Valley up to Audubon Hill, make that connection. We just completed a piece down by Parker Street, and we'll hopefully be working on the design issues for that middle section. There'd be a lot of walls and slopes and stuff, so we're working with neighbors and trying to make a connection all the way through to make that road much safer to walk on and a little bit more pleasant to walk on. So, and we have a number of other sidewalks we're working on, finishing up on Great Road, Central Street up by Idlewild, and there's a number of other sidewalks we're looking at on Parker Street, things like that. So that's a ever-evolving program that we've been doing and trying to keep it moving and make it safer for people to walk. So.
Hi, I'm Roland Bartle. I'm the planning director in the town of Acton. I'm going to talk about the Bruce Freeman Rail Trail. Construction on Phase 2A in Acton and in Carlisle and Westford has begun. The Bruce Freeman Rail Trail is a rail trail along the Penn Central Railroad line between Lowell and Framingham. The piece, the section from Lowell to Route 25 in Westford has been completed some years ago. Phase 2A is now beginning with construction. And it basically starts in Westford at the intersection of Route 225 and Route 27, and then runs south more or less parallel of Route 27, Main Street in Acton, comes by the Nathaniel Allen Recreation Area, then swings over to cross Great Road on a new bridge that will be constructed, and then it runs parallel behind the businesses along Great Road into East Acton, and then Phase 2A will end at Teamworks in East Acton. From there, going south into Concord and Sudbury all the way into Lowell, those phases will be following. They are in the engineering phases, and as you go further down in the planning stages. Kristen will say a few things about the contract and the blog.
Hi, I'm Kristen Guichard, the assistant town planner for the town of Acton. The contractor selected for the Bruce Truman Rail Trail is SBS New England, and MassDOT will have a resident engineer working on the project providing oversight. They'll be giving us updates here, and we'll be providing information to you on a blog from the town of Acton website. There are a few ways to access information for construction updates. Right now, it's posted under News and Announcements for Bruce Truman Rail Trail Construction Project. You can also go to the manager's blog on the left-hand side of the page and click on the Bruce Truman Rail Trail Construction Project under All Blogs. If you want to receive notifications by email or by push on your phone, you can click the Notify Me by email, under the blog, or by phone.
Thank you, Kristen. Construction on the Bruce Freeman Rail Trail in Acton is scheduled to go through 2017, and we hope to see you on the trail in the fall of 2017.